Praise God, praise God. Well, hallelujah. Thank you for this beautiful day.
Yes.
And we just want to welcome everybody, those of you that are watching, those of you that are viewing, some of you that are listening. We just want to welcome you. Amen. So happy Sunday morning to you. And happy Father's Day.
Yes.
Amen. Feliz domingo por la mañana y feliz día de los padres. Amen. So we want to welcome you to New Beginnings Church of the Big Bend. Bienvenidos a la Iglesia del Nuevo Comienzo. So what do we do now? We just want to rejoice and be glad, amen? Because God gave us a wake-up call, and we're here, and we're alive. And so, praise God. Thank you, Lord. And this is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it, amen? So, praise God. What I want you to do now is just prepare yourselves to receive, amen? We always mention this, but we need to know this. We need to, God has something for us, and we need to be ready to receive what he has for us, amen? How do you like my banner? It says, Father's love.
Yeah.
And it says, as a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. Amen. And that's Psalms 103:13. So praise God. We're going to be studying that a few minutes. But we want to welcome you. Prepare yourselves to receive. God wants to bless you, encourage you, change you, and correct you. You know, so you know that's what a father does. He wants to correct his children to make sure the scripture says, let's go there. God, that's good. I like
yeah.
that. Let's go there. In Proverbs. Let's go to Proverbs. Wow, we opened it up with the word so fast. Proverbs.
Proverbs.
22:6. Let's see what it says. 22:6 says, it says father, mother. But it says, train up a child in the way he should go,
mm-hmm.
and when he is old, he will not depart from it. Mm-hmm. Amen? So, this is to fathers and mothers. We have to train our children. Amen? But we try to send them to everywhere else except us teach them, you know? And sometimes we try to get rid of them and not have them, you know? So, let's not talk about that. Amen? We want to be fathers and mothers that are obedient to what the Word of God says. And when
yeah.
you talk, we're going to be talking about the commandment. He's given us a commandment, amen? And we must be obedient to it. So anyway, prepare yourselves to receive, and we want to welcome all of you, amen?
Yeah.
So before we get going any further, grab your Bibles and say it like I mean in church, amen? This is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I have what it says I am. I can do what it says I can do. Today, I'll be talking the Word of God. I boldly confess, my body's alert, my spirit is receptive, and I'll never be the same in Jesus' name. Woo, hallelujah. That is amazing to him and do what he tells us to do. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to be talking about our not only Father's Day, but about our perfect Father, our Heavenly Father. Amen. But just sit back and listen to this and be receptive.
Yeah.
You know, I put this, I've got a few slides for you, and I put this one first, because without this day, and without God giving us this new
yes.
day, we wouldn't have a Father's Day.
That's right.
So it says, this is the day the Lord has made. I, José, will rejoice and be glad in it. Psalms 118:24. If you don't have that highlighted in your Bible, go into your Bible, highlight it, amen, underline it. And where it says we,
put stars around
scratch
it.
That and write a line through it and just put your name on there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, whatever your name is, just say, I will. Okay, José will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. We're so world conditioned, you know, and we let circumstances and the world dictate what kind of day we're going to have. And we get around friends and people that are going to dictate what kind of day you're going to have.
Mm.
If you go by what the Word of God says,
mm.
you're going to rejoice and be glad in this day because he's
yes.
given us a new day to serve it.
Amen.
Amen. So don't go by those other things. Go by what the Word of God says.
Yes.
That's why it's so important that you know the Word. It says
yes.
if you know the truth, if you know the Word, it's going to set you free.
Yes. Yes.
It's going to set you free from all these negative things people
mm-hmm.
and the world's trying to teach you.
Oh yeah.
Amen. And go by what the Word of God says.
Yes.
Amen. So you know what? Maybe windy outside, maybe snowing, whatever the weather may be, guess what? I'm going to rejoice and be glad in it.
Uh-huh.
Because God has given me another day to serve it. Amen?
Yes.
Whew, I can't. Well, I mean, we can just stay right there and preach on that. Praise God. Amen. So happy Father's Day. Go to the next one. Here we go. We got a few of these. Happy Father's Day. Keep going. Oh, I like that. this one. Happy Father's Day.
Yes.
Looks like the one Jesse sent me. Thank you, Jesse.
You're welcome.
Keep going. Feliz Día de los Padres. El Señor te bendiga y te guarde. Número 624.
Yes.
Welcome, brother. Keep going.
Father's Day.
Happy Father's Day.
Right.
It says direct your children into the right path.
Yes.
And when
yes.
they are older, they will not leave it.
That's
and
right.
we just read that from the King James. This
yes.
is another translation here. It's Proverbs 22:6.
Uh-huh.
Direct your children into the right path.
Yes.
And when they are older,
yes.
they will not leave it. You know, sometimes we go and do the bad, and then we come and tell our children, don't do what I did.
Uh-huh.
Do the right thing.
Uh-huh.
No, we got to be good examples. And, you know, we're going to look at a scripture that the Bible gives us in Ephesians about being imitators of our God,
mm-hmm.
being imitators of Him, you know. So quit using the excuse that, this is the way the Lord made me. No. If you're still doing the old thing, then you got to get born again.
Yeah, yeah.
Amen. We got to pray for you.
Amen.
Get born again and start doing what the Word of God tells
yes.
you to do and imitate your Heavenly Father.
Amen.
And you don't hear Him cussing and fussing
That's
and
right.
drinking and doing all these other things, then you need to correct yourself. Get your life straight and be the perfect Father. Be the Heavenly Father. Be the Father that He wants you to be.
Yes.
Amen. Come on now.
Yes.
To all fathers viewing, listening, living in heaven. Some of us, our parents are already in heaven. So, hey, Mom, Dad, I already told Mom Happy Mother's Day on Mother's Day and told Dad Happy Father's Day. So, Happy Father's Day. Amen.
Yes.
Keep going, Carmen. Happy Father's Day. The greatest gift I ever had came from God.
Mm-hmm.
I called Him Dad. So are you. Amen. All of us are here because of a dad,
yes.
a father. You wouldn't be here without a father. Amen.
Yes.
Praise God. So we want to say thank you and praise you, Lord, for giving us our Father.
Yes.
Amen. To all you fathers out there, we say we love you, we thank you, we honor you, and we miss you. I miss my parents, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And it's okay. I can talk to them and say, you know, they're in heaven. I can say, Happy Mother's Day, Happy Father's Day. Or I can just talk to them on a daily basis. It's okay. There's nothing wrong with that. John 3:16 says, For Father God so loved the world, He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. God, Father, our Heavenly Father, gave His only begotten Son.
Yes.
Sacrificed His Son that we might have eternal life. Amen? Keep going. It's in there somewhere. That's okay. Happy Father's Day. The righteous man walks in his integrity. His children are blessed after him. Proverbs 20:7. If you don't have these, write them down. These are good. Amen?
Yeah.
Praise God. We got to be a good example for them, you know. No, I'm not going there. Anyway, Psalms 103:13. We just quoted this from our banner here. I'm going to give you a couple of translations here. And we have it also, Carmen, if you want to advance to it. It's in there. Just find it. It's Psalms 103:13. It says, as a father is kind or compassionate to his children, so the Lord is kind and compassionate to those who honor him or fear him. This word fear is good word. Fear him, honor him, respect him, honor, you know.
Yes.
So Psalms 103:13, this is the NIV. The one I just read to you is a Good News translation.
Mm-hmm.
The NIV says, as a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him.
Mm-hmm.
Compassion is good. You know, we
yes.
talked about compassion. You can have compassion on people and you can help them.
Yeah.
You don't feel sorry for them, but if you have love and compassion for them, you can help them. Amen. You can pray for them. So, praise God.
Yeah.
Compassion and feeling sorry for them are totally different.
Yes.
And I'm going to read it to you from the Amplified. 103:13 says, just as a father loved his children,
uh-huh.
so the Lord loves those who fear and worship him
yes.
with awe, filled respect, and deepest reverence.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. So this fear is good. Amen. Just gotta have respect and honor him.
Yeah.
So he tells us, thank you, Heavenly Father, for loving us. And thank you, Lord Jesus. And we want to say, thank you. Amen. Praise God. And now we're going to get into our commandments. You thought you forgot about them, but we didn't. Amen. So, you know, first one we're going to look at is Exodus. If you go to the Old Testament. We got to go through these because some of us need to hear this.
Yes.
Some of us need to hear this. Chapter 20, verse 12. This is what my Bible says. I don't know what translation you have, but it's okay. Just go to Exodus 20 and verse 12, and it says this. It says, honor thy father and thy mother, that thy days may be long upon the land,
yes,
which the Lord thy God has given thee. Mm-hmm. Amen. So, I just wanted to read you that. Lord, when he's talking about commandments, he's talking about a command that he's given us.
Yes.
It's not something that you want to slide through.
Right.
He says, honor your father and your mother and your father. Amen.
Amen.
So, we need to do this. And we find fault, we find excuses, and we find all kinds of things to skip this. But God has told us what to do.
Yes,
so
yes.
We need to do this. Honor your father and your mother, that your days may be long upon the land which the Lord your God is giving you. This is a New King James translation. Now let's go to Deuteronomy chapter 5. Let's go up a little ways there. Chapter 5 and verse 16. Hallelujah. Praise God. Verse 16 says, honor thy father and thy mother,
yeah,
as the Lord thy God has commanded thee, that the days, that thy days may be prolonged, and that it may go well with thee in the land which the Lord thy God has given thee.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So he's telling that he's commanded it. It says, God has commanded thee. So he's commanded us to do this.
Yes.
So whatever excuses you have for not honoring them, for not communicating with them, not being there for them, forget about it. Mm. You know, just ask forgiveness. We're going to be talking about forgiveness. Forgive and forget and press on. Amen?
Yes.
So praise God. This translation in New King James says, honor your father and your mother as the Lord your God has commanded you, that your days may be long, and that it may be well with you in the land which the Lord your God is giving you.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. You know, you want things to go well? You may be doing things, you may think you're doing things right.
Yeah.
But if you're not honoring,
that's it.
You know, you're going to go through some things.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And this is your choice. You have a choice. And some of us, we're going to be talking about choices too. And there's a lot of choices right now that we're not obeying.
Yeah.
And this is one of them. We need to honor our father and our mother. We need to honor because God has told us and he's given us a commandment. Amen. So let's go to Ephesians now. Ephesians chapter 6. Now we're going to the New Testament and see what Ephesians tells us. Ephesians. Okay. Ephesians chapter 6. 1 through 3. It says children. What does Father God call us? He's our Father, so he calls us children. Remember, I've told you this many times, but once you're born again, you can stop calling yourself a sinner.
Yeah.
I sin, but I could ask forgiveness.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? But now, he's my Heavenly Father,
yeah,
and I'm his child.
Yes.
Okay? So, he says, children, okay? It says, children, obey your parents in the Lord, mm-hmm, for this is right. And verse 2 says, honor thy father and mother, which is the first commandment with a what?
A promise.
That it may be well with thee, and that and thou may liveth life long on earth.
Amen. You want to live long? You may be doing everything well, except this. But if you want to live longer, he says, he commands us to honor our father and our mother. Amen. It's your choice.
Yeah.
And we have many choices to make, but
yeah,
this is a choice we need to obey. Amen. Let's see. The easy to read translation says, children, obey your parents in the way the Lord wants.
Yes.
Because this is the right thing to do.
Mm-hmm.
The fifth commandment says, you must honor your father and your mother.
Yes.
This is the first commandment that has a promise with it. And this is the promise, that all may go well with you.
Yes.
And you have a long life on earth. Again, it's your choice.
Amen.
You know, careful. We talk about speaking faith-filled words. We talk about words having life and death. So we select the words we choose. Amen. So still, we want to select the right words, and we want to select to honor them. Amen. To honor them. That's your choice. We celebrate Father's Day once a year. So happy Father's Day. God has given each one of us a father. Thank you for my Heavenly Father. Thank you for my Father. None of our fathers are perfect. Even the best fathers have flaws, imperfections, mistakes, weakness, failings. You know, as children, you may compare your father to another father. This might be doing something better, or might be doing something that you like. But as a child, as you learn, pray for your father and your mother. Amen. And pray for your father and your mother, and Father God will touch them. Father God,
yes,
will correct that. Amen. That they may, their spiritual eyes, that their eyes may be open to do the right things. Amen. So praise God. He is your father, and you pray for him. But on Father's Day, we want to focus only on the good and not the bad.
Mm.
The good teachings, the good times, the good memories. Amen. A lot of times we just focus on the negative things. Come on now.
Yes.
We only look at the negative things. I don't want to get on it right now. Father and Jesus teaches us to forgive and forget.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. John 3:16.
Yes.
Jesus was sent to the cross and sacrificed for us.
Yes.
Amen. But let's go. I mean, you probably don't remember this. I want you to know this. Let's go to Luke 23. Because we're talking about forgiveness. Let's talk about Jesus. Jesus came into Jerusalem, and he was welcomed as a king. And then a week later, they're crucifying him, and they're beating him. Amen? And now, they beat him bad, and he's on the cross. Luke 23 and verse 34. Amen. Verse 34.
Yes.
Okay. They welcome the king. They hail the king. And then a week later, they're crucifying him. They're beating him. And Jesus is on the cross. They've stabbed him. They pulled. They've done everything. Beat him. He is bad. The Bible says he is not recognizable. And he's up there stripped naked. And people can see him. And yet, verse 34 says what? Verse 34 says, then Jesus said, who said this? Jesus says, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Now, if Jesus, the Son of God, was beaten, he could have said, Father, I can't take this anymore. Just kill them all. He could have slayed them all. But he says, forgive them.
Yes.
You know, some of us haven't even gone through what Jesus went through. And we hold it against people. And we don't want to forgive. And we're talking about not only days or years. We're talking about long time. We're holding something against somebody.
Yes.
We need to forgive and forget. You know what? He says, if you don't forgive, he won't forgive. So we need to forgive.
I'm talking to somebody. Come on now. We need to forgive. He says, Father, forgive them.
Yes.
And guess what? He forgave them. He sacrificed his son, and now the son is sacrificed, and he's saying, Father, forgive them for what they do. Mm-hmm. They don't know what they do. Matthew 6:14-15 says this. For if you forgive men what they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive men their sins, guess what? Your heavenly Father will not forgive you. You can mark that down, Matthew 6:14-15. It says, if you forgive, he'll forgive you. If you don't forgive, he won't forgive you. Amen. So we don't want to hold those things against us. We don't want those extra weight on us, okay? We want to forgive. Amen. Matthew 18:21-22 in the NIV says, then Peter came to Jesus and asked, Lord, how many times shall I forgive my brother when he sins against me? Seven times? Jesus says, I tell you, not seven times, but 77 times.
Yes.
That's a lot of times.
Yes, 490 times.
490 times. That's a lot of times. So I don't think you're going to sit there, Mark, and say, well, this is one, and this is two, and this is three. No, best thing to do is just say, I forgive you, just like Jesus forgave. You know, he didn't hold it against them. So we need to forgive and forget and press on with the things of God. The enemy is going to see to it that somebody's going to rub you the wrong way, that things are going to go wrong, things are going to happen to you, and we blame it on God. Amen? And we need to forgive and forget. 1 John 1:9 says, confess and God will forgive you.
Yes.
For your sins. It goes like this. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just and will forgive our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. Amen. So look at the good in people and not the bad. Amen. Because we're always looking at the bad. Amen. And we're always comparing instead of completing. Amen. Instead of completing one another and seeing the good in people, we're always looking and seeing the bad.
Yes.
Why? Because we want to compete and we want to be higher and better than others, you know. Well, just be what God called you to be, you know. We've talked about the physical body and the many parts this physical body has. Which is the best part in this physical body?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. But they all work in unity. Yes. And they all serve well. Yes. And we need to do the same thing as the body of Christ. Is whatever your part is, big or small, it doesn't matter. Serve him well.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And don't compare what you do with each other.
Yes.
I just worship him and I do it unto him. And somebody has problems with that, that's their problem.
Yeah.
Lord, I'm just doing it unto you.
Uh-huh.
Amen. So do your part. I'm doing this unto you, Lord, and I'm going to do my best.
Yes.
Amen.
You,
we do our best. We try to do our best for the world and impress the world, impress men, but we can't do it for God.
Mm.
Amen. Perhaps your father is still alive. Well, praise God. Thank you, Lord.
Mm.
Maybe he's in heaven still. Thank you, Lord.
Mm.
Thank you for giving us or giving me a good dad.
Yes.
Honor him. No excuses. It's a command. It's a fifth commandment. Amen. Hey, I've told you about my military time. When you're military and you're given a command, you just don't skip it.
That's it.
If you want it, or maybe, when you're given a command, you go by it.
That's it.
And they'll get to you. Mm-hmm. Amen. So when they command you, you better obey.
Mm-hmm.
So God has given us some commands, and we need to obey them.
Yes, we do.
Amen. We just don't slide by them. There are so many ways to stay in touch. Well, let me go back. If your father is still alive, visit with him, call him, write him, text him, email him. There's so many ways to communicate with him. Nowadays, with media is so good. There's so many ways to reach him. So many ways. If he's still alive, there's so many ways to reach him.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if he left, if he's gone. And you're still mad at him? Still, forgive him and forget and press on. You know,
You're not doing anybody harm except yourself.
Yes.
Amen. Love, accept, forgive, and honor him. Fix any wrongs. Fix the past. No excuses. Just let it go. Amen. Praise God. So this morning we want to take a look at the one perfect Father, our Heavenly Father. John 3:16 again says, for God,
yes,
our Father God, so loved the yes. world that he gave his only begotten Son, uh-huh. that whoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Heavenly Father, we should honor him on a daily
yes.
basis.
We,
it's called relationship.
Yeah.
Amen. When you have relationship with him, that's what Christianity is all about. Mm-hmm. Having relationship with your Heavenly Father. Talking to him. Visiting with him. You know? I can't express that more. Not once in a while on emergency cases or when I feel like it or maybe yearly
mm-hmm.
but on a daily basis, honor him, give him thanks.
Amen.
Thank him daily. Show gratitude. Show appreciation
mm-hmm.
daily.
Mm-hmm.
This is a daily thing. Amen.
Yes.
This is also called relationship.
Yeah.
God gave us 10 commandments, not 10 suggestions.
All right.
The fifth commandment teaches how to honor and respect our father and our mother.
Mm-hmm.
The first commandment with a promise.
Yes.
Amen. I want that promise. I want that long life. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And I want that long life because I am here honoring and fulfilling the mission God has put me on.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And I thank my father and mother for giving me, for raising me and giving me that opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So now thank you, Lord. And I want to honor them so that I can press on and live as long as I can until you call me home to fulfill that mission that you have called me to do. And I will. Amen. Because the Bible
yeah.
says I can do all things through
all
Christ.
Things.
Amen. One reason God includes this commandment, it runs against our human nature.
Huh.
As humans, we want to do the opposite.
Yeah.
You know, a while back, there was something going around this, oh man, that's bad. Is that good?
Mm-hmm.
That's bad. I said, I was going around saying that's bad,
mm-hmm.
but it was a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Why did we switch that? You know, the enemy comes to steal, kill, destroy.
Mm-hmm.
Amen? Our tendency, and of course, all this is going right now. All these riots, all these things that are happening right now.
Mm-hmm.
And the enemy is going to see to it. Steal, kill, destroy.
Mm-hmm.
What do? Pray.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you don't care for a person. You don't care for the president. The Bible says, pray.
Yeah.
Amen. If my people pray, you know what's going on with the country? It says, if my people pray,
mm-hmm.
where to pray? What do? Pray.
Mm-hmm.
You don't like the president? Pray. You know, if you don't like the president, know this. Jesus is still on the throne.
Yeah,
it's it. Amen. Jesus is still on the throne. But Jesus has told us to pray for our leaders.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
So we need to pray.
Yeah.
Amen. We want to fight God's authority.
Mm.
We want to fight parents' authority.
Yeah.
We want to fight all authorities. Work, school, the neighborhood, the police, the church. We just want to fight it. We just opposite. Want to go against it. We want to be free. You know, for one time, the king asked, who should I release, Barabbas or Jesus? And they say, release Barabbas, a murderer.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus, one that's never committed any sin. And they want to release Barabbas instead of Jesus. You know? I mean, this is wrong.
Mm.
You know?
Yeah.
It says, Barabbas released instead of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
That's not right.
Yeah.
We want to go on and do our own thing, the prodigal son.
No.
You just want to go and say, hey, give me what's mine. Thanks for raising me or whatever. You know, I just want to take what's mine and go and do my thing. And there's many people out there like that.
Mm-hmm.
But guess what? He found out. It's best to come home. It's best to come home.
Yeah.
There's no place like Father's
no
house.
No place like home.
Yeah, no place like home. Thank you. Yes, there's no place like home. Come back home. Amen. If you got any sense, you'll know. You'll come home. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. There's a lot of prodigal sons and daughters out there. They just want to do their own thing.
Yeah.
You know, some of them never coming home.
Yeah.
But still, we want to fight authority. Mm. Amen. We must learn to be obedient. Obey.
Yes.
Here's what you need to do. Commit, submit, surrender.
Uh-huh.
Commit, submit, surrender. Okay? That's what we need to do. Just commit to Him, submit to Him, and surrender to Him.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Just, if you never have given your life to Christ, now's the time.
Yes.
Amen. You see what's going on in the country? Instead of getting all crazy and wild, just say, Lord, I need you. We need you.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
You know? You don't know how to pray, just say, Lord, we need your help.
Yes.
Help.
Help.
Help. But if you never accepted Christ, now's the time. Amen. Anytime is the right time. Now's the time.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
And there you go. Thank you, Carmen. Proverbs 22 and 6 says, train up a child the way he should go. So mother, father, this is what God wants us to do. Mm-hmm. You know, we wait, we send them off to somebody else and try to let them raise. And we, hey, you know what? I like my career too much. I'm just going to let somebody else do it for me.
Mm-hmm.
And they become something else. And they'll hook up with the world and be what the world wants them to be.
Mm-hmm.
Amen? So let's not do that. Train up a child the way we wish he should go.
Yes.
Some fathers have celebrated many birthdays. Some fathers, this might be your first time. Awesome. Well, what I want to say is congratulations to all fathers.
Yeah.
Amen. Congratulations. God loves you and we love you. Amen.
Yes.
Father's Day, we focused on what? The good qualities.
Yes.
The teachings.
Yes.
The examples, the talents, the abilities. Don't bring up the bad. Don't bring up. Just say, hey, happy Father's Day.
Yes.
Good memories. The good times.
Mm-hmm.
Remembrance. Recollections.
Yes.
Want to forgive the past. Want to forgive the hurts, the fails, the mistakes, the imperfections.
Mm-hmm.
None of our fathers are perfect.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what? Forgive the past.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. It's a new day, new beginning. Amen. It's time to press on.
Yes.
You're still the mother and the father. Be the best mother, be the best father and mother. God has placed these kids, these children, in your care. Take ownership. It's so easy to find a way out and just say, abort. It's so easy to say, send them somewhere else. I can't do anything with them.
Oh, gosh.
Well, if you would have raised them right, train a child the way he should go, you wouldn't have had those problems.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. But now you're having problems. God has placed these children in your care. You plan to have these children. Don't say, well, you're a mistake. No. It's always the children that suffer and say, we don't want you. We didn't call you. We didn't need you. Amen. That's the wrong thing to say. We got to take ownership. You know? Now we got to deal with God. Now we got to deal with God. You think that's easy? Getting rid of them. Now we got to stand before God and say, what happened? You stand before Him and say, I gave you these children. And what did you do with them? Amen. You aborted them? You got rid of them? He wants to hear. So I'm going to read you a story here in a few minutes here. Joseph was the stepfather of Jesus, but he received Jesus as his own.
Yeah.
Amen. I don't know if I should say this, but I'll wait. God chose Joseph to be the earthly father of Jesus. The Bible tells us, the Gospel of Matthew, that Joseph was a righteous man.
Yes.
His actions toward Mary, his fiancée, revealed he was a kind and sensitive man. When Mary told Joseph she was pregnant, listen to this, he had every right to feel disgraced. He knew the child was not his own, and Mary, apparently unfaithful, carried a grave
social stigma. Joseph not only had the right to divorce Mary under Jewish laws, he also could put her to death by stoning. Stoning Mary. Although Joseph's initial reactions was to break the engagements, the appropriate time for a righteous man to do. He treated Mary with extreme kindness. He did not want to cause her further shame, so he decided to act quietly, but God sent an angel to Joseph to verify Mary's story and reassure him that his marriage to her was God's will. Joseph willingly obeyed God in spite of public humiliation he would face. Perhaps this noble quality made him God's choice for the Messiah, earthly father. But Joseph had a choice, and he chose the right thing. And he had a visit from the angel saying, you know, this is from God. Amen. So guess what? He still had a choice.
Yeah.
And he chose the right thing.
Yeah.
Amen. So God has given us our children, you know.
Yes.
And we need to make the right choices to raise them. Amen. And do right and train them the way they should go.
Yeah.
So praise God. Amen. Woo. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So fathers, we must be imitators of our Heavenly Father. Amen.
Yeah.
Ephesians, let's go to Ephesians 5, 1 and 2. So this morning we want to talk to you about our Heavenly Father, the perfect Father. Fathers, be more like Him and our hopes more in Him. Amen. And this is, be the best fathers and imitate Him. Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 1 and 2. Even in my family, I've heard this. You know, I was born this way, and nothing can change me.
Mm-hmm.
I guess God is not strong enough to change me. But King James says, Ephesians chapter 5, and verses 1 and 2, says, be ye therefore followers of God as dear children, and walk in love as Christ also hath walked as doubtless, and hath given himself for us an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet smelling savor.
Yes.
This is the Amplified. The Amplified says this, therefore be imitators of God.
Mm-hmm.
He says, copy him and follow his example as well-beloved children imitate their father.
Yes.
Verse 2 says, and walking in love, esteeming and delighting in one another as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a slain offering and a sacrifice to God for you, so that it became a sweet fragrance. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So in the Amplified, it says to be imitators of God, copy him and follow his examples.
Yes.
How do we do this? Well, we got to get in the Word of God and find out what the Word of God says about him.
Mm-hmm.
And learn about him. Amen. And be those examples. Follow his examples. So we can imitate our Heavenly Father. How do you know how to be? Well, read the Word.
Mm-hmm.
And copy his examples.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So don't say, nothing can change me. I was born this way, and I'm going to die this way. Well, yeah, if that's what you're saying, if that's what you want.
Yeah.
But that's not what the Word of God says.
Mm-hmm.
The Word of God says you can be changed.
Yes.
Amen. And I was going one way, but guess what? I've changed courses. I've changed. And now the Bible said in 2 Corinthians 5:17 that you're a new creature now.
Yes.
You're born again.
Yeah.
You're a new creature. Old things are past. New things have begun. So I'm making a change.
Mm-hmm.
That old is gone. I don't have to be that no more.
Mm-hmm.
And the new has come.
Yeah.
So I'm going to be the new person. I'm going to be an imitator and copy my Jesus and
yeah.
be like him. Amen. So that old stuff, that whatever you was doing, whatever habits you have, whatever language you had, whatever bad talk you had, all that bad habits you had, all that is gone. The new thing, I'm going to imitate my Heavenly Father. Amen. I'm going to copy him.
Yes.
Amen. Mm-hmm. So praise God. So I like those. Keep going, Kirby. There and there. Says, honor your father and mother, that your days may be long upon the land which your Lord, your God, gives you. And of
mm-hmm.
course, that's Exodus, that's commandment 20, verse 12. Keep going. And this is the other one, Deuteronomy 5:16 says, honor thy father and thy mother, as the Lord thy God has commanded thee. And you can take that thee out of there and put your name there. That thy days, your days, may be prolonged, and that it may go well with you.
Yes.
And scratch that, put your name in the land which the Lord thy God has given thee.
Mm-hmm.
Keep going. And we read all these. We're just catching up on those. It says Ephesians 1:3, 6:1-3 says, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this
yes.
is right. It says number 2 says, honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with the promise, that it may be well with you, and you may live long on earth.
Long here.
You choice. It's your choice. Amen.
Yes.
Keep going.
Praise God.
Here we go. Ephesians, we just read it. 5:2. Imitate God, therefore, in everything you do, because you are his dear children. Live a life filled with love,
yes.
following the example of Christ. He loved us and offered himself as a sacrifice for us.
Yes.
A pleasing aroma to God. Another translation.
Yes.
But this is good. Amen.
Yes.
Imitate him. So,
yes.
you know, a lot of us raised to imitate all kinds of things. We want to imitate all kinds of people. You know, especially athletes, you know.
Yes, oh boy.
We want to imitate the wrong sometimes. But we need to imitate our Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Amen. We need an encounter with God.
Yes.
Keep going.
Thank you, Lord.
Proverbs 23:22 says, listen to your father who gave you the life, and do not despise your mother when
yes.
she is old. Amen. Man, these are good. If you don't have
yes.
them wrote down somewhere, you need to write these. Amen.
Yes.
Keep going. He compares our Heavenly Father to our earthly father. Matthew 7:9-11 says, NIV, if his son asks for bread, would give him a stone?
Mm.
And verse 10 says, or if he asks you for a fish, would give him a snake?
Mm.
11. If you then, though you are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Heavenly Father give? With your Father in heaven, give good gifts to those who ask. Amen.
Amen.
He don't want to punish you. He wants to bless you.
Yes.
Amen. He wants to bless you. He says he come that you might have life and have life more abundantly.
More
abundant. Amen. Keep going.
Thank you.
And of course, Matthew 6:33, on a daily basis, we need to have our priorities set up to honor him first. And must seek first the kingdom of God, his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Matthew 6:33. Keep going.
Yeah.
This is the scripture, our banner here. Just as the Father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. Amen. Honor him, bless him,
yeah.
love him, reverence him. Keep going. Choose yourself this day who you will serve. As for me and my house, we'll serve the Lord.
Yes.
Joshua 24:15. You make the choice. You decide. As for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a father, head of the house. You know, as for me and my family, we're going to serve the Lord. Amen.
Yeah.
Thanks, God. Thank you. We're almost there. And we're almost done. Remember to celebrate and honor your Heavenly Father daily, on a daily basis. Amen?
Yes.
Praise God. He's my provider. He's my disciplinarian.
Mm-hmm.
He's my security. He's my person. He's my personal. He's personal. He's always there for me. Amen?
Yeah.
So, you let him be there for you. Amen?
Yes.
Praise God.
Amen.
So we barely touch who a father is. He's a perfect heavenly father. But Father, he always wants to be there for you. Mm-hmm. He says he never leaves you nor forsakes you. Amen. Some of you that walked away, it's time to come home. It's time to come home. He wants you to come home. Amen. Mm-hmm. And quit running from him. You can't hide.
Yeah.
It's time to come home.
Yes.
Whew. So fathers, I challenge you to be the provider of your family, to protect them, to be the best of your abilities, to discipline your children, train them to be godly children, to be personally involved in the details of their lives, to fight against being absent in their lives. They need you there, and you need to be the imitator of God, asking him to be and make you more like him.
Yes.
Huh. You'll never be God, but you can grow in his character. Since your children want to be just like you, you need to be more like God. Your children want to follow you and be more like Dad. You be more like God so they can see the God in you. Amen? So praise God.
Amen.
Jesus. Close it right there.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Amen, amen. So happy Father's Day. Thank you for joining us. Amen. And if you never asked Jesus in your heart, now's the time. You know, say, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Be my Lord and Savior.
Mm-hmm.
I've sinned against you. I repent. And I've asked you, Lord, to come and receive him as the Lord and Savior. I receive you as my Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Wow.
So be happy. Rejoice.
Yes.
And start living for him. Start making a change. You know, start reading. Start living for him. Amen.
Yeah.
Praise God. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
Father, I just want to pray for all those that are watching and listening right now.
Yes.
Have a hurt in their bodies, Lord. I want to speak healing in their bodies, Lord.
Yes.
Father,
thank you, Lord.
Bible says that by Jesus Christ we are healed.
Yes. Yes.
And so I just speak whatever hurt, whatever needs to touch right now, Father God, you touch it right now. Body line up with the word of God and be healed right now.
Yes.
We receive it now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So be healed.
Yes.
Praise God.
Yes.
I love you. And it's giving time.
Yes.
Those of you watching or listening that would like to give your tithe or offerings, you can still do that. And just go to our website, nbcbigben.com, and press the donate button. Those of you that want to mail it in, NBC PO Box 252, Marfa, Texas, 79843. And again, we want to say thank you and happy Father's Day. God bless you.
Yeah.